Okay, so that proof didn't work. Is there one that does? Well, no. As it turns out, the set of languages is uncountable. We'll prove this by contradiction. So suppose not. That is to say, we'll let L1, L2 be the set of languages over an alphabet sigma. Here I'm giving them an enumeration. And we'll also let X1, X2, etc. be the strings in sigma star. We know that has an enumeration. We are then going to build a table where the columns correspond to the strings in sigma star, and the rows correspond to the languages. In each element in the table, we'll put a 1 if the string is in the language, and we'll put a 0 if it is not. Now we're going to consider a very sneaky language defined as follows. It consists of those strings xi for which xi is not in the language li. In effect, we've taken this diagonal here in the table and just reversed it. Since we're assuming that the set of languages is countable, this language must be lk for some k. But is xk in lk or not? You see from the table here, we've defined the row lk such that in every column, the entry is just the opposite of what is on the diagonal. But this diagonal entry can't be the opposite of itself. If xk is in lk, then according to the rules for lk, it should not be in lk. On the other hand, if xk is not in lk, then it should be in lk. Another way to think about this argument is to say that this language here must be different from every row in the table because it is different on the diagonal element. In any case, we have a contradiction and can conclude that this enumeration of the languages was invalid since the rest of our reasoning was sound. This argument here is known as the diagonalization trick, and we'll see it come up again later when we discuss undecidability.